As a keynote speaker, COVID meant that I had to switch from in-person presentations and workshops to delivering virtual keynotes or workshops. Hello, hello, my name is Sal, and in this channel, we explore the strategies and the tools to help you with your mindset, confidence, and public speaking. In this video, I'll be sharing my top tips for virtual keynotes and workshops. I know some of you probably don't want to hear this, but there's no running away from this. Tip number one is you need some good lighting, and you're better off getting yourself some professional lighting instead of trying to rely on the sun, especially if you live in a cloudy or dark country. I've posted some links on the description box below of the type of lighting that I use, just in case you want to give those a shot. Tip number two is choose a background or a backdrop that looks professional and matches your brand colors. I know you have the option to blur your background or use a virtual background, but I would not recommend any of those. Unless, of course, the event organizer wants you to use their branded virtual background. And here's why. A blurred background reduces trust between you and your audience because it seems like you're hiding something from them. I know that blurring your background might seem like an innocent thing to do, and it might make your video look tidier, but the psychological effect of blurring your background is that people on the other side of the screen can't help but wonder, what is he, she, or they hiding? Equally, a virtual background can sometimes chop certain parts of your body if you move around too quickly. Tip number three is use high-speed internet that you can rely on. I know this sounds so obvious, but unstable internet connection can be very, very distracting to your audience, to the point where it actually kills your presentation. What I love to do is have my phone hotspot ready to use as a backup just in case my internet crashes. I don't usually have any internet connection problems when I'm in the UK, but when I go abroad or when I use the hotel internet, it can be a little bit unreliable. And finally, tip number four is bring your elevated emotions of joy, love, and excitement with you. This is probably the most important ingredient of a successful virtual presentation. Bearing in mind that you are essentially separated by a screen, you need to bring twice the level of positive energy to that virtual room in order for it to be effective. So if your audience is initially feeling distracted by something else, you stand a higher chance of catching their attention with your high energy. No one enjoys being around sad, low energy, and monotonous people. Bring your best energy to the room because good vibes are contagious. If you want more tips to reduce any feelings of stress or fear, then you can watch this video where I share my top 5 tips that keep me confident and calm on the day of the presentation. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if you have, be sure to subscribe, share with a friend or a colleague, and hit that like button so I can continue making more videos like this just for you. Have an amazing day, take care, and I will see you on the next one.
To book Sel for a keynote or workshop, go to www.selamade.com/speaking.